Yo, this is my Fallout 3 Let's Play, Vury Hard, and I have this screen right here with the toggle free cam on because I need to get a screenshot, and for some reason the Steam screenshots are not working with Fallout 3 right now. So anyways, this is going to be a challenge run. Obviously I've already done Fallout 101, I exited it, nothing special happens there, nothing ever does happen there that's real special. Obviously I do have mods installed as well. If you've never seen Fallout 3 before, then maybe you have no clue, but the game doesn't look that great by default. So I installed mods. Those will be in the description below. Nothing game changing, all textures, E&B related, that sort of stuff. That's pretty much how I always play Fallout 3 New Vegas, just texture updates. But yeah, I had something else I was going to say. And what was it? Oh, right. What's the friggin' challenge? Basically, no armor, no companions, no stimpaks. Well, no armor. I'm going to be wearing this for the entire run. Obviously, at one point, I'm going to be heading to... I might do Operation Anchorage. You can't bring any stuff with you, though I guess I could console command.
Who the hell are you?
So, I don't know. We'll get there when we get there. And I skipped over that dialogue because I'm so used to playing this game that way. Anyways. Whoa, calm down. Who the hell's Moriarty, bro?
Kyle Moriarty, the owner of Moriarty's Saloon in Megaton. That sack of shit is convinced that I'm some crazy junkie who stole money from him. Look, I don't know who you are. I'm not just handing over my life's earnings to you. You do that for me? I never expected anyone to care enough. Here you go. Thanks, kid. You're all right.
Cool, 300 bottle caps. Thanks, lady.
Not a good idea.
Stop looking at me. Darn it. No, this isn't Fallout 4. I can't tab and friggin'... Oh, now those shots are hitting her. I thought they were totally gonna miss. You've lost karma. Oh well, I got a bunch of sweet stuff from it. Her body's not covered. Let's go steal some stuff. Shut up, radio, stupid enclave radio. I'm coming into this 1000% like unprepared. I just installed Fallout 3 earlier and decided that I'm gonna start it right now without even thinking about what I'm going to talk about or anything like that. Let me go ahead and... Oh yeah, let's get rid of... I can get rid of this. I console commanded this in. Oops, that's not what I wanted to do. How do you drop shit again in this game? Right click? Yeah. I console commanded it in because in the last... episode of my Fallout New Vegas Let's Play, How to Destroy New Vegas, I used that naughty nightwear because before that I'd been using power armor, and I was like, here, look, for the last one I'm gonna use this naughty nightwear because it's funny and I can destroy these nerds without having like any damage resistance. Security armor, 15 weight, god dang, dude, that's what's holding me down, and it ain't even worth the caps. I also do not remember the controls for this game that well right now, so it's going to be a real learning curve. Relearning curve, rather. So let's go ahead and... son of a gun, I forgot. Let's save. I'm also very afraid of this game crashing. It is notorious for that, especially when you start installing mods. Also, the frame rate is periodically dropping in-game. It might be because I have other crap open, but I really doubt it. I don't even know where I'm going right now, bro. Let's, yeah, following in his footsteps. Go to Megaton, right there. Don't have much HP left, so I kind of want to stick away from, having to deal with anyone right now. There's a few mole rats. Oh yeah, look at that. I got the enhanced camera so I can see my own body. Look at those beautiful textures on the tunnel snake's jacket there. Oh man. Look at that. Look at that. That bounce. That bounce. Oh, this guy. My buddy John would come up in front of these guys who are asking for water, and he'd drink his own water in front of them and then pow right in the head.
Oh, thank God. Someone new. I need water, please. Water.
Will any water do?
I've been drinking this irradiated shit, and I can't do it. I just throw it up now. I need purified water, please.
I have to go now.
But please, if you find some, please.
Yeah, whatever, bro. Whoa, look at that EMB light in my eyes. That deputy weld over here. Let's go and make our way into old Megaton. Oh, by the way, I also have, I decided to install the level 99 mod, because if I hit level 30 before this is over, I'm not gonna stop. I'd stop playing. I find it so boring when you hit the level cap. What up,
Sims? Name's Lucas Sims, town sheriff, and mayor too, when the need arises. I don't know why, but I like you, girl. Something tells me you're all right.
My jacket.
So welcome to Megaton. Just holla if you need something.
Nice hat, Calamity Jane.
So that's the way it's gonna be, huh? That's fine. That's fine. Just as long as we understand each
just
other.
Just Josh and brah.
This here is my town. These are my people. You so much as breathe wrong, and I'm gonna fucking end ya.
All right.
God, I hope you ain't one of those psychotic quiet types. So, is there anything else I can do for you?
Because the lips are kind of blue, eh? I see a bomb over your left shoulder right now. So, what's that about?
Nope, sorry.
Actually, just ask where the dad right there.
I got enough fires to put out in this place that I don't have time to keep tabs on every visitor. I'd ask around town.
Let's discuss this bomb.
What about it?
Don't you think someone should disarm that thing?
I don't trust any of the locals to tinker with it. Besides, most people don't even realize it's still a threat. And hell, Cromwell and those crazies from the Church of Adam, they worship the damn thing. Why? Do you think you got the know-how to disarm it? For good?
That's exactly what I have. Yeah, I could see about disarming that bomb for you.
Oh, all right. Fine. But listen here. Just take a look at it first. Go easy.
Go easy.
If you get the job done, there'll be 100 caps in it for you.
This entire town is living on a bomb, and this guy wants to offer me 100 caps to save everyone here? No. 9% speech.
Not
dang
an
it.
Option, I'm afraid. We aren't exactly rolling in cash down here.
Alright, 100 caps. I'll take a look at it.
Great. Go ahead and see what you can do. Just be careful.
Gotta go.
Good luck.
Yep. By the way, my character's name is Vury Hard. First name Vury, last name Hard. So, I guess that means Liam Neeson's name is Dad Hard in this game. Attempt to disarm the bomb.
Yes!
Yo, Sims! I put 9 points in explosives just for that. 9 points was enough to top them at 25, which is what you need to disarm it.
I'll be damned. You did it, didn't you? You disarmed that thing. Here's your reward. Hell, why don't you move in? Could use someone like you. Got an empty place here you can use. Here's the key indeed.
What?
It ain't much to look at.
What?
But talk with Moira. She's got random odds and ends you might be able to spruce the place up with.
Okay, bye.
Take care.
So, let's go heal up in my new house and my new bed. What do I want to do this early on? What do I need? Let's go drop a few points in this, and then I'll cap that at 25 next time around. And right now we'll do sneak. And let's go ahead and do Black Widow. The whole reason I started using female characters in RPGs was pretty much because of Fallout 3 when I first played it. This is the most obvious perk to get early on. I decided to go with Swift Learner because I am gonna be passing level 30, like I mentioned with the mod, because if I'm doing a Let's Play, then I don't want to have to stop at level 30, because I find the game is so boring once you stop leveling up. On my personal runs, I stop right away. I hit level 30 and it's like, wow, that was a fun run. Usually it only takes like 24-ish hours to get there, something like that. So let's go ahead and talk to Wadsworth. I was about to call him Codsworth.
Your personal robotic butler. I am here to look after your...
Yeah. What can you do for me? You can get me something to drink. Sweet. I'd like to get a haircut. I don't actually want one, but I do want a screenshot of that later on, because who knows, maybe I'll use that for the video icon. Anyways, thanks Wadsworth, you're a homie, man. What's in here? Bottle caps, give me them. Yes, full HP. Yes. I guess next up is Moira Brown. Oh my god. That's a gross sky. Disgusting. I don't like it. I don't know if it's a combination of the E and B and the fact that I have a night sky texture installed and the two of them are conflicting, or if that's just how it is. I played this game without an E and B before. But yeah, I don't think I played it with an E and B last time, because before Fallout 4 came out, I did an entire stream of Fallout 3. I streamed an entire playthrough of it.
Hey, I hear you're that stray from the vault.
Oh, cool. Yep, nice to see you. Creator side supply, if you don't say.
I'm working on a book about the wasteland. It'd be great to have the foreword by a vault dweller. Help me out, would you?
Okay, I can't stand your voice, but yeah, sure. I got plenty of to say about the vault. This outside place is amazing. In the main room, I can't even see the ceiling.
Yeah, you wouldn't imagine how hard it is to replace that big light bulb up there, too. That's great for a foreword. Open with a joke and all that. Here, take the suit. Something tells me you might need it.
I just remembered.
In fact,
blah, 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 yeah. If you give her funny replies and like snarky replies or whatever you want to call it, you get a better perk at the end of this, because it's like plus 3 or 4% crit chance, some crap like that. pay? What sort of pay and what sort of work?
Let's see. Dealing with radiation, testing and experiment.
That sort of stuff.
But for all
yep.
that, I can pay yep, you with yep. caps, meds, chems, and maybe even a few of those unique inventions, if you do a good job. Interested?
Sounds good.
Well, it's a dangerous place out there in the wastes, right? People could really use a compilation of good advice, like a wasteland survival guide.
Good name.
For that, I need an assistant to test my theories. I wouldn't want anyone to get hurt because of a mistake. Nobody's ever happy when that happens. No, then they just yell a lot at me with mean, mean words.
Okay, I guess I'll help you with this survival guide.
Oh,
yep. Let's talk about this food. What are you looking for? Super-Duper Mart? Okay. Let me see what you got for sale, lady.
Absolutely.
She's a weirdo. Baseball bat or the police baton? Baseball bat. How many caps she got to spur? I usually always hang on to one of these jumpsuits. It's like a weird memento, but nah, thanks. Can't be using those eyeglasses for that extra OP1 damage resistance. Tinted reading glasses. Whatever, bruh. Let's just get rid of all this crap. I will, however, hang on to the armored suit. And if we could get rid of the stupid BB gun. Get rid of the stupid BB ammo. And what ammo you got, lady? 10 mil? Give it. Oh yeah, I got my... Do I got any stims to get rid of too? Because I don't be needing those. Can't remember if... Can't remember if you get anything from stims later on, if they're used for anything. Because I'm so used to Fallout 4, where it's like you can use them to craft refreshing beverages, which is what made my Buffy Let's Play quite simple. Especially early on. Ooh, those refreshing beverages are so OP. And what am I getting early on? I guess the hunting rifle, I could stock up on that. Maybe a shotgun. And then let's go ahead and drop 3 more of these. Won't need the whiskey or the vodka. What else she got under aid? Nothing. Okay. Ugh, I just took all of her caps. I think I gave her more than she needed. Because I don't think it gives you a warning in this game. Hey man, you're selling her way too much stuff. She doesn't have that many caps. It's also weird pressing quick save right now because I just finished playing Mass Effect 1 today. Did another run of that. Pretty much did every quest. So my controls that I'm used to currently are the Mass Effect 1 controls. And yeah, that's my story. Anyways, in Mass Effect 1, when you hit the quick save button, it like stutters for a second. And then you know, obviously, that it's saved. It also makes a sound effect. So I'm not used to this right now, where it doesn't make any sound effect. And it doesn't stutter at all. Who are you? Hey, wait, I gotta talk to Stanley. Is that his name? The dude. That dude's skin is mad yellow. He needs to get away from living by this bomb. Gross. Walter, friggin' that's what it is. I'm looking for my father, middle-aged guy. Maybe you've seen him. How can I help?
Now, I don't expect...
How many leaks are there?
From the pressure in the plant, my guess is that there are 3 of them scattered around town. Check along the pipes.
Look at this guy's
valves,
eyebrows.
But they might be a bit tricky to spot.
What's going on there? Some weird textures. Hey, looks like he's like got white brows. You know, like it looks like he's got like some white skin under there. Like he's black and white. I don't know. Anyways, I'll keep it in mind, bro. Gotta go. Let's go fix us some leaky pipes. Do those classic opening quests in Fallout. I've started so many runs of Fallout 3 and Fallout New Vegas, and like the stuff I've done so far is like the stuff I do every time. So these ones I'm quite used to. After this, I'm not sure where I'm going to go, because I got a couple options. I could just skip to Tranquility Lane. That's always funny and fun, but you don't get as much experience that way. It's just a quick way to level up. And then where's the last one again? It's like right over here somewhere, but you gotta drop down onto it. Now he's getting a little loush coming to it. Where are you at? There it is. I'm also not used to the fall height in this game. What damage I'll take if I... Ugh. This pipe's always a bitch. There we go. Oh yeah, I have a sprint mod. Look at that. Because I don't want to be playing this game really slowly. I'm not going to use it to like run out of combat too much, I don't think. Only if I'm like really screwed. It's mostly there to speed things up when I'm playing. So it's like you're not just watching me walk for 50 minutes.
What is it?
Pipes are fixed.
Well, I'll be. The pressure's up in the plant. It looks like all the leaks have been fixed. Thank you, stranger. Thank you. But listen, it's only a matter of time before they burst again. And someone like...
Make me a deal. You can buy scrap metal off me. Sounds good to me. I'll bring you the parts I find.
Good. This just keeps looking better. Those parts will... What do you need?
Hey, man. I think I have some scrap metal for you. Interested in buying some? Just take all the scrap metal I have.
Well, all right.
Yes.
Let me count out...
Peace, bro. Alrighty. Got lots of ammo, got lots of experience. There's no bomb anymore. Oh my goodness, it's such a good let's play so far. What am I doing, dude? Super-Duper Mart? Am I good enough? Am I good enough for that? What am I gonna run into on the way there? There's a chance I run into a Deathclaw. It's always a random encounter. I got that in my Twitch stream of this. Anyways, I think one story. Oh, is this a guy?
Ah, fellas.
Yeah. Let me see what you got, bro.
Please.
Yes, it is a guy.
High quality problem solvers.
Perfect. What a way to start. Look at that luck. Let's get rid of one of these shit ones. Actually, I'll just keep one. And the 32 pistol sucks, yeah? Yeah. I'll hang on to that ammo just for the, and yeah, screw that. I'll get rid of that and that. Buff out. I don't need any of them stims. Ashtray. This isn't Fallout 4. Pre-war money? No, pre-war books is what I want. Turpentine? I need that for something later. 5 mil. Yep. Coolio.
Give me a shout if you need.
Peace out, Lucky. What was I about to talk about? Oh yeah, one story I always tell when I do a Fallout run of any sorts, whether that's one of the ones I've streamed or one of the ones I've uploaded to my channel, like the How to Destroy New Vegas or Buffy, is how did I start playing Fallout? And hopefully this recording isn't too dark. I could mess around with my ENB settings or something. On my screen, like my right monitor has OBS and it looks fine to me, but you never know when it's actually finally uploaded to YouTube. I've had people comment on some of my Dishonored 2 tip videos like, bro, this is really dark. I can't see what's going on. The only one that is too dark is like the very first two of my Let's Play, and then I fixed it. And then after that, I think it looks pretty great. But periodically, I guess some people's settings on their monitors, something, just not enough contrast or what, but I'll get people commenting on this one video especially. I forget which one it is. It's just one of the tips, and they'll say, yeah, this is way too dark. Like, I cannot see what's going on. Oh, I know which one it is. It's how to get the rune in the basement on mission 3. I think it's mission 3. I don't know. Yeah, people comment on that one quite a bit, and I just say, thanks for watching. No problem for helping. And of course, it's a freaking Radscorp. That's a second. That's one of the. That's a second random encounter that can happen here. Quite a few happen at the Super Duper Mart. I don't know why they chose that. But there's a Deathclaw, there's the fighting that usually happens between the raiders. And then what else happens here? Oh, the Fire Lance can spawn here. I've never seen the Fire Lance spawn. I've played this game so many times. Never gotten it. The unique alien blaster. I mean, as far as I know, right? Because you could get it and then have no clue. Anyways. Jesus, what am I talking about? I'm supposed to be talking about how I started playing Fallout 3 the first time. 2008. I was in school. And, one day, this dude in my class had been pestering me for a while. He's like, dude, can I come over? Because I'd always walk home for lunch. He's like, man, can I come over? Can I come over? Can I come over? And, you know, he'd just been asking me for ages. And I always said no, because it's like, he wasn't that close of a friend. He was just a dude in my class. And he's a bit of a weird guy, honestly. But anyways, there had been a point where Fallout 3 came out. I heard really good things about it. I got my Xbox like 2 months after it did come out. And when I was looking for those initial first games to try, Fallout 3 was on my list. So early that year, like January, February, the following year, 2009, I guess. I can't remember exactly what the timeline was. End of 2008 or 2009, something like that. He came over and I had rented it Fallout for the the second time. Because the first time I played it, I just couldn't understand, like, the mechanics of the game. It was really even my first time playing, like, honestly, count Metroid Prime. It was, like, my first time playing an FPS. Oh, I take that back. I'd been playing a ton of Halo at the time, but I still sucked. But, yeah, I just didn't understand the map. I didn't understand the compass. I had no clue where I was going. I ended up lost in the subway system, because when you leave Vault 101, it's just like the quest updates, find your dad. And I was like, you're kidding me. Where do I go? And I was just wandering in this open world, no clue. So I returned it to Blockbuster. And then next week, my buddy rents it. And he's like, dude, like, I don't know why you're talking smack about Fallout. Like, I just got it. And man, it's so fun. I was like, what? Like, he's like, yeah, I got pretty freaking far in it. Yada, yada. Her eyes are scary. And yeah, he had been talking really great about it. So I decided to give it another shot. This dude comes over for lunch. And he comes over and he shows me what's up. Like, he had happened to also play it and he knew what was good. So he actually brought me to the Super-Duper Mart, like, showed me how to use the quest markers. And then, you know, that was one of the things he did. He came here and he wiped out all the raiders. And I was like, oh, that was sick. And then once I finally understood how to use the Pip-Boy and all that, then, yeah, I was a fan of the game. And so my interest in Fallout 4, or Fallout 3, rather, was born, but I'm much more of a New Vegas player. Jesus. Come to me, please. What? Homie's whipped out his 10 mil? Whoa. Do you get health when you level up? I don't think so, yeah. It's a Skyrim thing. Skyrim Fallout 4. Where is his dead body? A psycho tech helmet. Oh, there we go. Explosives. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Science. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Sneak. What do we got? Edumacated. That's what we need. Save on that. Level up. If I could get to those water fountains on that side of the store, if I get over there, we're in the clear again. We're in the clear. Maybe that's what I'll do. Go ahead and run this way. And this way. I don't know how long I'm going to keep these, by the way. 40 minutes max, I think. Witcher, it was like 43 minutes was the target, and most of them went longer because there's a lot of dialogue in that game. Oh yeah, by the way, I'm recording this on, what's the date today? The 15th. This will be uploaded on like the 20th or 21st because I still have... I finished recording Witcher on like the 13th of January, 14th of January. Wait, that's no good. No. I finished it on like the 7th or something like that. And the last upload date is the 19th. Oh my gosh. He's got an assault rifle, doesn't he? He does. I forgot that guy was a tough one. Just fuel up on some water. Water. And what else do we got here? Oh yeah. Pip-Boy light. That's a thing. Nice bright white light. I was expecting it to be green. Because that's how it is in Fallout 4. Until you change it. I was thinking that it was green, and then in Fallout 4, they made it so that the light changes on based on the color of your Pip-Boy, and that was one thing they changed. But no, in this game, the light doesn't change based off the color of your Pip-Boy. That's a mod that makes that happen. A mod that I used once and didn't like the green light. And then I used the green light for quite some time on Fallout 4 until I was just like, man, this is gross. Okay, what do we got here? Look at this one in the back left over here. Completely bent back, doing the limbo, shooting at the roof. Not very much a threat, hey? Look at that. I don't even know what to shoot at because their body's flailing all over. Look at that. This guy's eyes are very scary. Ooh, Tales of a Junktown, Jakey Vander.
Stop moving around so much.
The Raiders are funnier in this game than they are in Fallout 4. Stop moving around so much. LOL. Metal box. Hey, the farmer's key. Don't need it though. I already picked the lock, right? Pretty sure the pharmacy key is the one back there. Or maybe it's the one in the room that I'm about to go into in a sec. Nice. I'm a beast at lockpicking. They call me Lockpick Nick. Not actually. Okay, let's go ahead and... Oh wait, yeah, this is the pharmacy key, right? Okay, let's throw on the light. I'm mostly just interested in scrap metal.
We're back. Somebody...
Oh no. I'm so not used to the looting in this game. Holy Jesus, it so sucks compared to Fallout 4 quick loot. I should investigate if there's quick loot for Fallout 3, because I know there is quick loot for New Vegas. I know there's quick loot for Skyrim. Exit. I want to say that you need this for a shish kebab. You need it for something. Something. Alright, let's beast it up. Plate, glory, spoke. Meh, ends with an E. Plate, spoke. What? Yay. Hacking. Run maintenance.
Loading personality.
Does AR count as small gun? I do not remember much about this game. Yo, is that a Nuka-Cola? Jesus, this friggin' ENB or texture or whatever the hell makes those hard to pick apart from normal bottles. I want them to glow more. I gotta do an investigation to see if there's Nuka-Cola super glowing mod so that they're easy to spot. So I swear there's more, or like one more on the shelf over here. But I guess I'm wrong. Anyways, if there's ever anything that you want me to talk about, if you're watching this far in, leave a comment, and I'll freaking talk about it. Maybe. Look at this guy. Oh, he was like the Headless Horseman there for a second. That was cool. I don't know what mod would have done that, but something's messing this game up large. Unless this game is just more messed up than I remembered it being. Yo, am I... Did I hit caps lock? What's up right now? I'm over encumbered. What did I pick up? Get rid of this crap. There we go. Oh gosh, I heard that voice at the last second. Where'd it go? Is that the cart that hurt me? I forgot about that BS. Keep hitting tab to back out of the loot. Come on. Come at me. Oh, I thought she ran. Whoa. That is so different in this game compared to Fallout 4. Any words? That's going to be it for this one. I'm going to go ahead and feel up on some sleep or whatever. If there's a mattress over here, I think there is. Either way, then it'll just end up being water or something. So I'll do that. And then next time I'll be back at Megaton to return the quest to Moira Brown. So likes, comments, always appreciated. Thanks for watching. And until next time, bye for now.